This audiobook was created using text-to-speech software, and was not read by a real person. Please keep in mind the limitations of the technology when it comes to pacing and pronunciation. Thank you for listening, and we hope you enjoy the story. Star Wars. Galaxy of Fear. Book 6. Army of Terror. By John Whitman. Prologue. The small shuttlecraft glided through space, toward an enormous star destroyer. The shuttle was tiny compared to the large battleship. It looked like a speck of dust, floating through the void. But thousands of soldiers on board the powerful star destroyer trembled in fear, when they heard the name of the shuttle's single passenger. Darth Vader. Vader did not watch as his shuttle landed in the destroyer's docking bay. He was deep in his own dark thoughts. One phrase worked its way into his mind. Project Starscream. Months ago, Starscream had been a promising experiment, run by the Imperial scientist Borborema Skog. Now, it was all but ruined. Thanks to the interference of a scientist named Hul, and two meddling children. They had successfully wrecked the first five phases of Starscream. They had tampered with Devourin, the living planet. They had destroyed the undead research on Necropolis. They had neutralized the plague virus on Gobindi. And then, demolished the promising nightmare machine. Finally, they had shattered Gog's plans to manipulate the power of the Force. Vader clenched a gloved fist. Gog had hidden this last plan from the Dark Lord. Vader knew the scientist feared him, and had searched for a way to cancel out Vader's dark side powers. Fortunately for Gog, Vader thought, he died before I discovered his plan. I would have made him beg for death. Hul and his young companions had escaped from Nespis 8 just before Vader arrived. Even now, Vader's ships were combing the nearby star systems, in search of the escapees. Leaving the shuttle, Vader barely acknowledged the presence of the stormtrooper squadron that saluted him as he strode from his shuttle, his dark cape swirling behind him. He did not pause until he reached the captain of the Star Destroyer, who bowed nervously. "Lord Vader," the captain said. "Welcome aboard. The ship is yours to command." "Excellent, Captain," Vader hissed through his black, skull-like mask. Vader continued walking. The captain struggled to keep up with the Dark Lord's powerful stride. I trust your mission to Nespis 8 went well?" "It is not yet complete," Vader replied. "I have one thing more to do before Project Starscream is completely under my control." Vader knew the scout ships would not find Hul and his companions. But he did know where Hul would go next. He felt the dark side of the Force flow through him. He knew many things. He could not see the future clearly, but he sensed that it would end in bloodshed. He relished the thought. "My lord," the captain asked. "What are your orders?" "Tell the scout ships to continue their search," Vader commanded. "Meanwhile, set your course for the headquarters of Project Starscream." Vader flexed the fingers of his right hand. Yes, blood would be shed. He was sure of it. And he would be the one to shed it. End of prologue. This book is part of our exclusive series available to Patreon supporters. If you would like to listen to this entire book, please visit patreon.com/yjkaudiobooks. The link is also available in the video description below. Thank you for listening, and may the Force be with you, always.